we're going to be looking at a piece of shit game. Yeah, I know, big surprise, but here's an actual one. This game wasn't made by LJN or any of those other companies that made shitty NES games. No, instead, this one came out last year. So, yeah, we're not exactly going too far back into the past with this one, but before we go there, let me tell you a bit about a cartoon called Regular Show. Regular Show was created in 2010 by J.G. Quintal, who's also the voice of Mordecai in the series. It's about, well, on paper, it's about some guys who work in a park, and most of them try to slack off and have fun instead. Thing is, usually somewhere along the way, they get involved in some strange and often surreal situation. By the end of the episode, everything goes apeshit, and they have to find a way to fix it. Despite the surreal nature, the show maintains a very laid-back approach most of the time. Quintal said he created the show based on some of his student films, which might explain a lot. For example, in one episode, Mordecai and Rigby start prank calling everyone, only to try and prank the master prank caller, who ends up sending them back to the 80s. Which I find fucking hilarious, because the whole show feels like it's stuck in the 80s. They still watch movies on VHS and listen to cassettes, Mordecai and Rigby play what looks like a Sega Master System, and they even got the right to use actual 80s songs in the show. That is fucking awesome. Also, Mark Hamill's in it, voicing Skips, a Yeti who, well, skips.
Mordecai and I got the arms. Rigby, you got the legs.
Not that you could tell. Seriously, he sounds nothing like Hamill. Oh yeah, and every episode's only 15 minutes long, kind of like an Adult Swim original, except aimed at a younger audience. As bizarre as it is, the show is great fun, and I definitely recommend giving it a shot. And since this show apparently takes place in the 80s, I guess it'd only be fitting that a game based on it would be a tribute to classic video games. And that's where this one comes in, Mordecai and Rigby in 8-Bit Land. Interestingly enough, this game was actually made by WayForward, who in recent years had become famous for good licensed games and remakes. They made the new Aboyness Blob, both Batman the Brave and the Bold games, and DuckTales Remastered, all of which I really liked. But if LJN could make Maximum Carnage, well, I guess the same rule applies in reverse. Or to put it another way, this game is indeed a tribute to classic NES games, like Back to the Future, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Don't believe me? Well, let's take a look at Mordecai and Rigby in 8-Bit Land, and I'll show you what I mean.